Good afternoon, everyone. I would like to extend a warm welcome to all the PEX Council officials and to all the participants of the webinar. It is indeed my pleasure to have with us today the webinar on Export Credit Risk Management with ECGC Limited being organized by PEX Council. At present, a large number of countries in the world are in the grip of political and financial turmoil. This unstable political scenario is a major cause of concern and worry to Indian exporters. Since non-realization of export proceeds is viewed seriously by Reserve Bank of India and the banks, the problem of the exporter gets compounded, who is facing a huge loss in dealing with countries with unstable economic and political situation, and yet have to answer queries of RBI or the banks. Unfortunately, the knowledge and awareness about the export credit guarantee schemes is lacking amongst the exporter fraternity. This seminar is to acquaint the participants with the basic principle of the export credit insurance, the type of the covers offered by ECGC, its risk coverage, and the other benefits. The program would be of use and interest to all the exporters existing as well as those proposing to enter export business, or export professionals or organizations engaged in export business. PEX Council, the Plastic Export Promotion Council, is sponsored by Ministry of Commerce and Industry, Department of Commerce, Government of India. Its role is to promote Indian plastic industry globally. We provide trade assistance to Indian manufacturer and merchant exporters, whether it is SME, MSME, or large corporates. Any exporter who is engaged in activity of plastic exports or raw material, finished goods, semi-finished goods, machinery, accessories, or any allied products. To support and promote the Indian plastic globally, PEX Council undertakes various initiatives, which includes organizing Indian Pavilion under aegis of Ministry of Commerce and Industry at international exhibitions. The Council has been working on enhancing its digital presence. As always, we bring you news, opinions, and insight from the global plastic industry through our PEX Connect monthly digest magazine and PEX Council mobile app. We connect with members through online webinars under PEX Connect 21 and under PEX Connect 21 webinar series, and also connect members with the foreign buyers through virtual buyer seller meet. We hope that you all have found this useful. We do invite you to keep sharing your views and perspectives together. Sorry, somebody said something. We do invite you to keep sharing your views and perspective with us together. Let's build a great industry for all of us. I am pleased to welcome our guest speaker today of today's webinar, Sri R. Mahalingam, AGM ECGC Limited. He is a postgraduate in commerce with postgraduate in computer applications and postgraduate in taxation. May I request all participants to He has joined Corporation in 1991 and has worked in many places like Chennai, Mumbai, Delhi, Kochi. He has vast experience in international trade credit, risk management, and banking. He is presently posted at Bandra branch of ECGC. Sir, we are glad that you have joined us today and agreed to address our participants in this important webinar. I welcome all participants to this webinar and request everyone to take maximum advantage of the subject being discussed. We are sure that today's webinar would be helpful to our industry members and to all exporters. Stay safe, stay healthy. Thank you. I now request our speaker, Mr. R. Mahalingam, for his presentation. Over to you, sir.
Okay. Good afternoon, or in fact, rather good evening to all the participants. First of all, am I audible to everybody?
Yes, sir.
Is there any issue with regard to?
Yes, sir, we can hear.
Yeah, right. See, this seminar, this webinar, in fact, we can call it as a webinar, is just starting only. We are trying to connect with all the people because nowadays, as Sir has told, now worldwide everybody is facing a lot of issues with regard to health pandemic, and which has resulted in a loss of business, loss of lives, and loss of and a complete economy shutdown. And this is evident with all the claims. But we cannot leave it as it is. We, as a human being, we have got, as a team, we have got every determination to come up out of this pandemic situation and also make the economy in very good way. However, taking all these points, what is happening, what has happened, some sort of a precaution can be taken by every community, may it be the normal community by wearing a mask to avoid the pandemic, to keep your health in good book, or to save your life. Similarly, there are certain safeguards are there in the business also, so that any eventuality happens, in case of eventuality happens in the future, your business should continue, nothing should go bad. So that is the reason, you know, that ECC, in that scenario, ECC plays a very important role to make this business community survive in the market by, even though there is a loss or there is a backslash on your business, whereby the money loss is being compensated by ECGC to the exporting community, too, so that they can still continue to do the business and make the economy grow. So I have made my presentation here, not a lengthy one or bigger one, because the subject itself is such a vast one, and it will not be easy to know a subject within a period of 1 hour or 1.5 hours. So I have made it a short presentation, for maybe half an hour period or so. And afterwards, people can ask any doubts or any questions which can be answered, which can be addressed myself, so that I can clear your doubts or anything which you are having in the normal presentation. In case you have any of the, if you have any of your questions in my presentation, you can just in between also raise your hands to the host, so that I will stop it and answer your query. Right. So anything, both the ways are possible. So now let us start the presentation. And it is a very, what I say, it is not a elaborate, and I have tried to give to the maximum possible, I have tried to do it. The next page, sir. See, this is a proverb. Normally, a risk. How you cannot discover new oceans unless you have the courage to lose the sight of the shore. This is how the definition of a risk, which I have taken it from my old study book, and which is really true. At that time, when I studied, I never realized this quote. Now I find this quote is very useful to everywhere, even in the present scenario. Next one, sir. And saying is that anything is possible. It was said by an intellectual. And my experience is that contingency is not provided for or those which happen. Anything is possible, correct, but there are certain contingency not provided for is for those which happen normally. Next. See, in a normal business transaction, you cannot now dominate in the world by saying that I will do the business on cash and carry or you send me the advance. So credit is an inevitable one in not only life, you know, in the business, it is a, and also it is a inevitable in life, right? I will, in fact, somebody has told me we are born with a credit which our father or forefathers have created. We live with the credit and we die leaving the credit to our successors. So credit is inevitable, and each and every credit, how it helps in business growth and prosperity, I will tell you. To fill the, this is a credit is to fill the gap between need and availability of money. It is required to maximize the utilization of resources. One credit generates series of credits and multiplicity of activities. Attention of creditworthiness results in better business management, and credit is used as an effective marketing tool. So when you have an effective credit policy, your effective marketing will be very much there because that is a tool for your wonderful marketing background. Next one, sir. What are the risks in export transaction? First one, political instability, civil disturbances in number of countries such as Afghanistan, breakup of erstwhile Soviet Union, Syria, Libya, continuing events in Africa, South America, so many other places, Ukraine and other places also going on. Transfer delay problems due to scarcity of foreign currency in Mozambique, Argentina, Nigeria, and latest Ethiopia and also other Uganda and African countries. And you can see collapse of banks such as in Russia towards shift of market economy, then collapse of banks like Merrill Lynch, Lehman Brothers, and insurance companies like AIG, which has happened some 10 years before. Next, sir. If an international agency shows that in advanced economies, every day more than one new business is formed, more than one company changes its names, directorship changes, share ownership changes, company changes control, and more than one company fails every day. So it is like a clock go on ticking, adding slow and so slowly. Next. So there are certain general trade contracts are there. It is called as a know your customer, know their country, know their credit bank, understand the trade cycle, understand the terminology used in the trade concept, understand the transaction risks, understand the ground risk. Here is many of the people are not understanding many of these important terminology which are required in the trade concept. Because just to get an order as of today for your product is going to be very easy. So, however, if you go with this perception, like the four procedures, know your customer, know their country, know their credit bank, then you are entirely fulfilling the entire requirement of a trade cycle and also your trade concept, so that your business cycle will not get hampered, your business will flourish. Next. And what are all the types of risks involved in export credit? One is, first one, basically a political risk, which is very much there. Then there is a legal risk. There is a transfer delay risk. Then there is an exchange delay risk. Then there is a credit risk. See, all these risks, if you see it, one after one, it will be there. It is like a circle. It is, if one, it is not, one is not there, then another one will be definitely there. In certain countries, there may not be a credit risk much of it there, whereas there will be an exchange risk. In certain risks, there will be a legal risk. In certain countries, there will be a political risk, like Iraq and all. So everywhere, there is a risk involved. So however, you cannot protect everything with all your risk in other. In our day-to-day life, you can see it, there are a lot of risk involved, right from you get out of your house or even in your regular housework. There are a lot of risk involved. You cannot have all the risk foreseen or anything. But generally, what are all the normal risks which are normally there, is there in vogue for an export transaction or an export credit risk, has to be understood, and how we can mitigate the risk. Because mitigating a risk is very important. Because if I mitigate some of the risk, then I need not worry. If I can manage some personally, some 2-3 risks, then it is a very good management of risk. So credit risk management is one of the important role which has now become order of the day for any organization. If you are not managing your credit risk properly, then finally, somewhere in the long run, you will not be able to survive in the market or even anywhere else. That is the reason you have to know the different type of risk. Next slide. Now, the credit risk management, as I said earlier, there are two types what you can have it. In the export insurance, you can get it mitigating your risk. One is the risk involved in the goods while you are exporting it. In the goods, loss or damage to the goods are covered or can be mitigated by taking a marine insurance cover. Now the credit, what we call it as a receivables. There we have two types of risk. One is a payment risk, that is a credit risk. Another one is a exchange risk. Now with regard to exchange risk, today there are a lot of other avenues are available for forfeiting, factoring, or even you can have a authorized dealer's hedging also is there, where you can have a forward cover booking. You can mitigate that risk. Now comes the credit risk, that means payment risk. When it comes to payment risk, which is called, you can mitigate the risk by taking a credit insurance cover. Next, sir.
Hello. This is Biju Balakrishnan joining for the meeting.
Hello.
Hello, this is Biju Balakrishnan joining for the meeting from Kollam, Kerala.
Yes. Yeah. So when you have a credit insurance, it can cover our underwriting capacity. At a glance, if you see it, we are covering 237 countries. The coverage is not limited to one. It has a coverage of direct exports, deemed exports, project exports, merchanting export, consignment export, software export, servicing export, and IT enabled services also. Next. And we offer cover even to developing markets like Latin American, Africa, Asia and Asian countries. Just a moment. I will call you. And DPDA terms cover are acceptable in these countries also. We also provide cover for LC discrepancies and cover for LC opened bank with more than 1 lakh world ranking also are provided to the exporting communities. Now, what are all the basic risks covered by ECC is, one is a political risk, which is called as a country risk. The second one is a commercial risk. The commercial risk we can classify it into two categories. One is a buyer, another one is a bank. When we talk about the buyer, normally it will be an open account transaction or DA or DP. And when it is bank, then it is only basically a LC backed transaction. And what are all the risks covered here is, first one is under buyer risk, we cover the basic thing is the insolvency of the buyer. See, as you all know, aware, recently after this COVID, lot of companies in US have filed bankruptcy. Even companies, big departmental stores, or big players also stopped there. Suddenly they have filed Chapter 11 insolvency petitions. And this is very much common in European and USA and other countries. Now in India also, after this NCLT has come and IBC procedures have come, lot of companies have started filing insolvency petitions with the NCIBC court. So insolvency is a major risk which is covered. Now protracted default is nothing but a willful default that is covered. And third one, failure to accept the goods. This may happen on a DA terms also. Very simply is that some countries go by international pricing. Some products are being sold under the international market pricing. Today they might have placed an order with a price, and later date, when the goods arrive, the prices comes down. Definitely, they will not try to take the goods. So they fail to do it. Or sometimes it happens that the commodity or that fashion of the goods have changed, or the requirement for a particular type of goods is not there after placing the order. These things and all will force the buyer to not to accept your goods. In that case, the loss incurred by you also is covered under the credit insurance policies. And LC opening bank risk of protected default and insurance is also covered.
Sir, I have a question here.
Yes, certainly.
On protected default, many times buyers take the plea of, let's say, quality, which may or may not be correct. How does ECGC deal with that?
Sir, very simple, sir. See, normally we are now telling to all the customers, or even I am suggesting to them, to put a condition in the purchase order itself, any quality issue raised within a week, within 1 week or 10 days from the receipt of materials has to be informed to us. In case no issue is raised, so we assume that there is no quality issue raised. So this should be a part of your contract or your purchase order, anything, number one. And some commodities, there is a stipulation still in vogue saying that a pre-inspection certificate by SGS or quality certificate given by SGS is accepted. That is there in some of the product or commodities which are being exported. If that is a certificate is given with the quality standards, what is acceptable to them, then we don't question it. See, we also see the genuinity of the particular transaction. If a buyer is trying to raise a quality issue after the, when the payment has become due after 90 days or 120 days or 60 days, then there is a point in the Indian exporter asking for, saying that he is raising for a quality issue to avoid a payment. So we look at it in a liberal way. However, if assuming that once the goods reaches there, if the client, if the overseas buyer says that the commodity, the product what you have sent is not to the standard, there are damages or there are breakages or there, it is not the product which I have ordered, then there will be an element of truth will be there because he raises it immediately on receipt of the material. So in that case, you have to take care of those cases. If we, you can tell us, if you can prove us saying that your quality is good and it is only my, the correspondent says that he is trying to avoid the payment to, he is trying to raise a quality issue, filthy issues only for the purpose of avoiding payment, then the claims are all considered in favor of the Indian exporter only. The rejection on account of quality comes very less with 10% only. 90% we are paying the claims depending on the situation and depending on the correspondent what they are having with them.
Thank you, sir.
Next slide, sir. And risk covered me. Under this risk covered, political risk, we have categories with some political risk. War, civil war, internal disturbances in the buyer's country, transfer delay payment, shipment diversion due to lot of any other issues, then any import restriction. This point we have to, we are harping on it. See, if there is an import restriction is already in vogue in a particular country for ban, import ban on a particular product, after you are sending a shipment, if you come to know that ban is already existing, then there is no protection available. However, after you are sending some goods, their import restriction has come, then naturally it will be come. I will give you a small instances which has recently, last year has happened. In last year, October, till October, goods of Indian origin, agricultural goods of sesame seeds have been dispatched to European Union. Suddenly, one fine morning, European Union came out with a new circular stating that this presence of this particular chemical in the sesame seeds or this pesticide is not allowed. That was come in October, whereas a lot of shipment which are already sailed to European Union in September and August, when it reached, that became a new import restriction. Many of the clients could not take the material back. So that was covered by us and we have settled the claim. Just a moment. For the meeting, the webinar, let's consider. So that is the reason there is a difference between import restriction before the shipment and after the shipment. And last one, if there are any causes beyond the control of the exporter and buyer, that also is covered under the policy. Next. Risk not covered name. Commercial dispute, any dispute with regard to the client, with regard to the buyer and Indian exporter is not covered under the policy. And which are all the causes inherent in the nature of goods, like perishable commodity more happens and other marine commodities, that is not covered. Buyer's failure to obtain import license. This is a very important point. See, today, many of the people may not be aware or not. If you want to import a material in Nigeria, there is a requirement of M form. That is a license, import license by the buyer to import the material. If that is not available, then that is not covered. So you have to ensure that buyer is having the proper license to import the material wherever it is applicable. And similarly, insolvency default of agents are not covered. Risk covered by general insurers, whatever is the marine or any other risk, theft or not, are all not covered. Exchange fluctuation risk are not covered because already you have got a product from bankers as forward cover. failure of the exporter to fulfill the terms of contracts, if it has happened, that and all is not covered under the policy. Yes, somebody has asked, can you elaborate on a commercial dispute? Sir, this is a big line with regard to a commercial dispute. And if somebody says, can you say about a legal dispute what this is, somebody has to say there may be an empty number of legal disputes on there. Similarly, commercial dispute in the sense it includes quality or the earlier shipment dispute or pricing dispute, your packaging disputes, your dispute with regard to any of the transaction, your documentation, anything may be there. So these are all purely treated as a commercial dispute. Why it is not covered? Because we as an insurer are not the best judge to assess who is at fault. X is at fault and Y is at fault. So we have to judge everything by the papers which are given to us. So that is the reason we say, if you go to any place, if there is a dispute between two people, if you just enter into that dispute without knowing the what is the reason for those people's dispute, we will not, the person who is interfering or who is becoming a judge will not be able to give a judgment. Similarly, we are not here the best judge to assess who is right, who is at fault. That is the reason we say, if there is a commercial dispute, you both of us, buyer and yourself, talk together or come to a conclusion, then you come to the insurer. That is the reason we say commercial dispute. It is a big one. We cannot today identify commercial dispute. It can be any commercial dispute. That is the reason we are mentioning it as a commercial dispute. Next, sir. Somebody is asking Nigeria and all. I think they let them keep the chat because it is about a specific commodity, whether it is permitted or not. That and all, I will give an answer in the question answer session. Some of the important concept on this credit insurance policy is it's a whole turnover principle. There are certain options for exclusions or permitted, and it is a co-insurance. Co-insurance, it means we do not provide 100% cover. We provide 90 or 80 depending on the type of policy. And maximum liability is nothing but up to which the under the credit insurance, you can get a claim during that 1 year period. And what is a credit limit is nothing but a limit on the buyer to whom you are exporting it. And you have to submit a statement of export, which is called as a declaration. And unnecessary premium has to be paid. Prior approval has to be obtained for RC country means restricted cover countries. Out of the 237 countries, 9 countries are classified into RC2 countries like Sudan, Palestine, North Korea, or are all categorized as RC restricted cover category 2 countries where approval is given on each and every contract. So you have to take prior approval to shipments to any of these 9 countries. There are remaining another 19 countries where the approval is given for a 1 year period. So any shipments you are going to do within that 1 year period, you can get it covered. Please note that automatic coverage for countries in the RC group, restricted cover category 1 and restricted cover category 2 are not automatic. You have to take a prior approval, then only you can, it will get covered and necessary premium has to be paid. Next, sir. See, how do we underwrite a buyer? First one, based on the financials and creditworthiness of the buyer.
See, sir, I have a question on the earlier slide.
Yeah, please, sir.
Basically, when you say the credit limit is fixed for each buyer, Now many a times it is seen that on traders, the credit limit being given by ECGC is very low. And the normally the amount of business being done with him is at a much higher level. How does insurance work in that in such a position?
Sir, credit limit, what we mention here is that your exposure to the buyer at any point of time. Number one, suppose a new company is being, exporter is there in India, is trying to export to a new buyer in a new country, and the buyer is not in the business at all, suddenly is starting a new business, you cannot give them 1 crore, 2 crore directly to them. Even today, if you go to a bank, I am starting a business, give me 100 crore, give me 10 crores loan, definitely the bank may not give it. They will say that what is your projection, what is your capacity, and all the other factors also into taken into account. Similarly, the credit limit is approved based on their financials and other factors and the report what we get it. If a client who is already existing in the importing country and he is doing a business and his financials are there, then we underwrite as per, even we have given credit limits to the extent of 75 crores, 100 crores. Even we have given to Pier 1 in USA 125 crores. Now that Pier 1 has now become insolvent. So it all depends. It is not a fixed amount where we say for this buyer we will give 100, only 1 crore, for this buyer I will give 100 crore. No, this is a revolving one. It is a, anytime it can change it. So it all depends on your experience. That is how I said, how we are underwriting it. In the next slide, we are given.
Sir, we have seen that, you know, we have some buyers whom we have relationship for more than 10 years. Okay. Their balance sheet may not be very strong because they are just traders. So their profit percentage is very low. And but they are doing, let us say, almost like 5 crore per month business, but the credit limit what we get on them at any point of time is only about 2 crores. So if he pays in 90 days, which means that you need a 15 crore limit on him and you get a limit of 2 crores. No How problem, do we sir. Deal with that?
Yeah, you can give your experience with this customer for the last 1 year. What you have, as you have rightly said, 10 years you have a good experience. Give me the experience detail with that customer for the last 2 years. Based on your experience, we can go up to 10 crores.
All right. Thank you.
But that is the reason in our form also, we have mentioned this column. What do you have experience with the client? Please give us. Because many a times, the report seen given by the agencies may not be good, or they may not be able to know it at all. So that is the reason if your experience with them is a last 2 years is very good. Based on that also we are underwriting. If you see my next last slide, it is available there. Next. Yes. ECGC's past experience and exporters experience, we have clearly mentioned that. So if you have, again, there are two differences between ECEC past experience, exporter's experience. ECEC past experience means that you are exporting it and you might have not taken a cover with us till now. But some other exporter would have taken a cover and that experience would have already got uploaded in our system. So that experience also will get added to you other than the experience of your company. And we have got arrangement with many credit information agencies. If one agency is giving a report not traceable, we don't keep quiet. We refer it to another agency and get the report. And accordingly, we are trying to approve the limit. We are trying to maximize and accommodate the maximize possible. Next, sir. And a country underwriting factors taken into account, depending on the political situation, economic situation, relationship with India, what is the experience with ECGC, experience with other credit insurance, which is very important because no one in the world were ready to provide a cover for Iran exports to Iran or Iraq. Whereas ECGC was able to give cover to Iran and Iraq. not a single country was off cover from in ECGC, and we were covering to all the exporters, to even Iraq, Iran, when there was other world were not, other countries in the world were not exporting or providing cover. Next. See, broadly, I am not trying to now tell you which policy, what it covers, everything is. See, basically, all the policies, we have got a basket of policies. All the policies provide the coverage, what we have already discussed about earlier. So, whatever our policies, I have categorized into three major categories. One is specific transaction cover. Second one is a turnover covers. Third one is a exposure cover. Under the specific transshipment cover, specific transaction cover, you can cover a single particular transaction. Assuming that I do not want to take a cover, I have got an order from one particular buyer where I feel he is a new customer, I want to take a cover. You can take a cover for that particular transaction alone. That you have got a risk where you are foreseeing there will be a risk. That is called a specific shipment policy. It is based on the one particular transaction or one particular order. Even if there are two transactions, two particular shipments are going to take place in one order, that also can be covered under the specific shipment policy. Next. See, turnover covers are called as a SCR, XCG, and ETB policies or turnover policies. The exporter will insure his entire turnover barring certain exclusion mutually agreed with ECGC. Here, the monthly statement of exports and what state under the policy has to be submitted, and premium has to be kept in advance, and every month it will be reduced from the credit balance available with you. Next, sir. Exposure covers. Here, the exposure cover is that where you can go for any type of exposure, whether assuming that for a particular buyer, my turnover is going to be 15 crore. At any point of time, my exposure is going to be only 2 or 3 crores. So you can go for a policy for only 3 crores. The only advantage here is that you are not going to pay premium for the entire 15 crores. You are going to pay premium only on the exposure amount for which you are going to take a cover. Similarly, if you are coming and telling us my company is a lot, I do not want to make a premium for each and every shipment. I want to go for an exposure based policy to cover all my buyers. That also is possible by giving a multi buyer exposure policy, which what we are saying. So in short, what we are saying is the coverage has to be minimum 10% of your anticipated turnover on the all buyers or on a particular single buyer. If on a single buyer, your turnover is going to be 15 crores, you have to minimum take 1.5 crores. Similarly, under multi-buyer exposure policy, if your entire company's turnover is 100 crores, you have to minimum take a 10 crore policy. Next. If any of these policies are not suited, and you are saying my company is a large company, and my basket of buyers is more than 100 or 200, my volume of turnover is also huge, I will not be able to manage like this, then you can come to us, we will design or we will customize a policy according to the need of the customer. So that is the reason we said customized policy is also probable, but only disadvantage is there for customization, a minimum annual premium of 30 lakhs has to be paid, so that then only the customization can be considered. Next, sir. So these are all the various products offered, standard policy, small exporter policy, and these are all basically the same risk is covered, but depending on the customer what a needs these policy are being designed. Next, sir.
Sir, I have one question.
Yes, sir.
Sir, it is regarding that offshore trading. That our commonly exporters face, right, sir? So what kind of a coverage package would be given by the offshore trading, even if they, you know, sell their products mid-sea kind of thing? And also, sir, regarding the ECGC coverage the various alignments. I mean, first things first, sir, is regarding the offshore trading, sir.
Offshore trading.
And second, sir, and second also, sir, the custom bonded warehousing issue also, sir.
No, you are talking about
I think he's referring to, sir, is high seas trading.
High seas trading means you are talking about a merchanting trade. That means you are procuring a goods. Let me put it in a different example. You are in India, you are trying to procure the goods. You have got an order for a particular product. You are trying to procure, say, from Indonesia and export it to China without the goods touching the Indian territory. Am I correct, sir?
No, sir. It's not like that, sir. On the line, sir, what happens is they sell off their products on the custom bonded warehouse only.
Custom bonded
warehouse. The ECGC help, sir?
Sir, I see there is a difference between sale in a custom bonded warehouse and offshore trading, sir.
Yes, sir. I agree, sir.
You are getting confused with offshore trading.
No, sir. I am from the Plastics Export Promotion Council, sir. And yeah, I have got a query from our member exporter, sir, regarding the same.
Tell me, sir.
So the query was regarding, most of the members are trying to, sell off the goods during the offshore trading, right, sir? And some are trying to do the high sea purchase, that you are referring to. Fine, sir. It's also the issue of a custom bonded warehouse. So in that case, how can ECGC help the Plastic Export Promotion Council in getting their clearance done during the high sea purchase?
Very sir, high sea purchase, it is a purchase by the buyer, no, not the Indian exporter.
I agree, sir.
Yeah, I understood a little bit. Let me first try to clear them my doubt. See, when it is a high seas trading, where sale happened, the product what the buyer buys is on the high seas, correct?
Yes, sir.
Right.
Fine, sir.
Now, when he buys in the high seas, and who is going to be responsible once the sale is concluded in the high seas? Then what is the risk involved? What is the risk involvement in this there for a ECGC to cover?
Right, sir. But sir, just in case, sir, if he procures that license from ECGC,
sir, very simple, sir. Clarification is very simple, sir. Where you perceive a risk in it, and if that risk wanted to cover, if the IC sale has happened, there is what risk you perceive in that. If you tell me that, I can tell you the answer.
Sir, just in case, just because I was referring to your one of the clauses where you mentioned that in case of calamity or something like that, right? It will not be covered, right? So what should we say to our buyers that in case of calamity is not covered,
right? Sir, we are covering, ECGC gives cover for the credit you are extending to the overseas customer. When the goods are on the high seas, you are already got a cover of marine insurance.
Sure, sir. Sure. Agree, sir.
Okay. Then here the credit extension itself is not there. There is no risk as materialized. Risk has not matured when the goods are in the high seas or sale take place. But the credit, once you extend it, once he takes the good, then only the credit comes.
Fine, sir. I agree, sir. So we may inform the members accordingly, sir. Right, sir?
Yes. Yes. Yes.
Sure, sir. That was an issue, sir. And sir, the second issue also.
If you perceive a risk, what risk? You can tell us. I can give you a clarification, or we can tell yes, this is covered under this clause. I can tell you.
Sure, sir. Sure, sir. I'll get in touch with you, sir. Thank you, sir.
Yeah. Thanks. And these are all the various products which are covered. It's a small thing for MSMEs. Factoring also is available. What are all the specific covers? What are all the specific buyer cover to cover a specific buyer for to cover all the transaction to cover for large exporters? Everything is being shown in a nutshell. What we have discussed it. This can be because the reason is that with a little amount of time, features of each and every policy may not be available because each and every policy may not be suitable to every customer. For each and every customer, depending on the suitability, depending on the need, we suggest them, we tell them this policy will be suitable, everything. That is why we have just, but basic coverage in all the policies are the same. So next one. Thank you, sir. So now the question answers whatever they have. Any questions, I am here. They can raise it.
Sir. Good evening. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Sir, my name is. सर जैसे आपने अभी कहा कि एलसी डिस्क्रिपेंसी भी ईसीजीसी अलाउड करता है तो सर ऐसा बहुत बार होता है कि सर हम लोग एलसी में शिपमेंट करते हैं और हमारा कभी $200 कभी $500 कभी $800 कट के पेमेंट आता है तो सर ये सारे पेमेंट क्या सर ईसीजीसी कवर करता है सर अगर करता है तो उसके लिए क्या प्रोसीजर हमको अपनाना पड़ेगा सर
सर देयर आर सी दी नॉर्मली एलसी डिस्क्रिपेंसीज नोबडी इज कवरिंग इन द वर्ल्ड What we have found out, omission of full stop, comma are all treated as a discrepancy. There is no concept of minor discrepancy, major discrepancy. So, however, based on our experiences, we found that basically certain basic discrepancies we have classified as a major. For example, non-submission of original letter of credit is treated as a major discrepancy. And 99% of the discrepancy which we have faced and which we are facing in the LC transaction is shipment made after the LC last date of the shipment as stipulated in the LC. 99%. When we ask for it, sir, buyer ne mujhe phone kiya, hum log maal bhej diya. But here, under an LC, Once the LC is opened, buyer need not interfere in it at all. If anything is required, then LC opening bank has to give concurrence. Then only you can get export it after the LC date. In that case, it will be very difficult. That is treated as a major discrepancy. But invariably, if you export to Middle East countries, there will be a clause in the LC, $50 per discrepancy will be deducted. And 90% or 99% of the LCs, invariably the overseas bank which has opened the LC will try to fleece the money by citing three or four discrepancies. And you cannot say in your export documentation that not a single my documents are 100% discrepancy free. 99% of the document which are drawn under LC are discrepant documents only. But still you are getting the payment. And this is a biggest advantage for the LC opening bank to get a additional income of $300 per LC. That is the reason we say, if you have a insurance cover, take an insurance cover on a DP or DA transaction, take a credit limit, obtain an approval, do it a business on DA. In that case, this $300 loss will not be there, because if you take in a LC transaction, apart from the discrepancy charges, there will be LC opening charges, there will be LC advising charges, there will be LC negotiation charges. If you see all these charges, your profit margin will be entirely eroded. Above all, if by citing the discrepancy, this payment can be stopped by the LC opening bank anytime. So that is the reason we say it. But still, if you want to have a cover on his LC transaction, please approach our office, whichever, either in the Gujarat or Maharashtra, wherever it is, they will guide you how to go about it.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Sir,
hello.
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 Yeah.
Sir, my question is, how can ECGC help in merchandise trade transaction?
Yes, it is like any other transaction, madam. You only thing is, if you are taking a cover for under, if you are taking a policy with ECGC, you please give a letter to the office where you are taking a policy to include merchanting trade transactions also.
Okay.
And get it endorsed.
Okay.
Then it is like a normal export transaction. You pay premium, it will get, take a credit limit and pay premium, it will get covered.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Yeah.
Sir, hello. Sir, this is Rachit Jaggi from Faridabad. So we are exporting to Canada almost around 12 to 15 crores annually. But we cannot apply in ECGC because it says ki we do not have status holder certificate, which will be applicable only if we have 20 crores of export annually. So for small, I would not know if I am a small exporter as per ECGC, but they do not give us a guarantee because they say ki you need to have status holder certificate. Who so said, iska sir? Sir, ECGC department.
I think there is a wrong perception with I do not know. We do not deny, we do not say no cover available to any exporter. Even to a fresh exporter, we are giving it. For old exporter, there is no requirement of status holder certificate. The only reason for status holder certificate is there if you are sending the document direct to the buyer instead of through bank. RBI do not permit other than status holders to send the document direct to the buyer. Otherwise, ECGC provides cover to all exporters. Please go and approach our Faridabad office and
yes,
they will issue a policy to you.
Okay, okay, sir. Thank you. Sir. Because there was some confusion, I will check. Thank you, sir.
No, sir, no confusion. No confusion. We are giving cover even to a new entrance also. No worries, sir.
Okay,
sir,
thank you.
Good evening. I'm Ashish here. Sir, I want to know, suppose I get an order today and then I approach ECGC for a cover. So how many days you will require to assess and tell us whether you will cover it or no?
First thing is, if the buyer to whom you are going to export is already in my record and somebody is exporting it, immediately within 2 days you will get the policy. Whereas if the client is not in my record, take it 10 working days, you will get the policy.
Okay, thanks.
Hello, sir. This is Prashant Gandhi from Siddhi Engineers, Ahmedabad. Sir, I want to know, we are exporting to Europe and the buyer provides us about 50% advance. Mm-hmm. And balance, he says that they will pay after 15 days from the date of receipt of the good in his country, you know, after checking the goods. So suppose the consignment is of total 50 lakh rupees. And if I get advance of 25 lakh rupees, then do I need to go for insurance of only the exposure where I am giving credit of, say, about 25 lakh rupees, or the full consignment value, sir?
You have to pay, take a cover only for the 25 lakhs, for which you have to get the payment afterwards. When advance whatever received, there is no risk involved. There is no need to get cover.
Thank you very much, sir. Thank you.
Hello, good afternoon, sir.
Sir, I am Shoman Nundi from CRI Limited. Hello.
Tell me, sir.
Sir, I just want to know the total. Actually, we lodge a claim on November, and the ECJC now referred to this case to MAE, your authorized agent. But till today, this is not yet solved.
To whom, sir?
And this is a buyer exposure policy. And our goods sent to Sri Lanka.
Okay.
And the ECJC referred this case to MAE.
MAE.
Switzerland agency. Yes. Switzerland agency. ECGC.
Sir, I have a small correction. ECJC do not refer to any debt collecting agency. See, very simple. When a shipment has been affected, payment has not realized, as your Flexi Council chairman also has told, RBI and DGFT and banks are all now very strict in ensuring the overseas money foreign currency realization. So the money, what the claim, what we are ECGC giving is going to be only on INR. Your liability to India by for your assurance in GR assurance of bringing foreign currency from foreign country is still with the RBI. Your recovery efforts for recovering the money should continue. The claim what we are processing and giving to the client is to ensure that his working capital finance goes on and his business is not closed down or stopped. That is the reason. And we do not directly refer the case to any of the debt collecting agency. We tell the exporters, it is your money, please sign the agreement. There is a legal team is there. They will charge you only on the amount what is recovered by them. They don't charge fully previously before the money is collected. It is on a succession fee basis. Okay. Your claim is pending in which branch, sir?
ICICI Bank.
No. Which office of ECGC?
Calcutta.
You go and tell, meet them, saying that I have handed over the debt to the debt collecting agency. They will be collecting. The requirement is that you have to sign an agreement with the debt collecting agency and give a copy to the office.
Yeah, we already signed the debt collection agreement and also sent it to the.
If they have already given to them, they will definitely process. You can follow up with them. I think you go and meet Mr. Lakshmi Narayan Sahu there. He will help you out.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Sorry, sir. It's Santosh Singh from CRI only. The only thing we are worried about that it took too much time to process and documentation and other things. Like its payment due is from Sri Lanka, it's almost due date was over and we have applied in November. Then we come to know in February that we have to sign an agreement with the third party and we have done that. And after March, we are only following up and nothing is happening.
Sir, very simple. After March, April, May, even in my Bandra office also, I have got 30 people. I am working with only 8 people.
Yeah.
And worst scenario in Bombay is that we cannot have more than 25% of the people. The people could not travel by train or anything. Very difficult. We had to. So where 30 people work, 8 people are doing, think about the volume of pressure. And
I do understand, sir. I understand the problem, but the thing is,
my request is, please stand by with the government or ECGC or whichever organization during this difficult time. Definitely, we are here. Justice may be your decision may be delayed, but justice will not be denied.
No, but we are not getting any response, sir. We should at least get a mail that it is getting delayed because of less manpower or anything else.
No, don't worry, sir. You can go and meet Lakshminarayan Sahu, or there is a regional manager is there, Mr. Y. Sudhir. You can meet him.
One more request, sir. Like in past, we used to apply for ECGC. First, they used to charge 2,000 rupees for inquiry. And after we get the confirmation, then only we used to pay the fees or policy premium amount. Mm. Now, at the time of inquiry only, we have to pay the premium also.
Yes,
so
sir.
So, why it's this changed,
is,
sir?
This is not our change. This is a change by IRDA. IRDA, even I will tell you, I have taken a medical insurance policy long time before, where I have paid the premium, I have filled up the form, I paid the premium after my medical checkup is over. But recently, when I applied for my wife or my child, what they say is, first you pay the premium, and after the medical certificate, if it is, then this is a IRDA stipulation, what they say, premium and proposal has to be received along with it together. If you are not able to give the limit, refund the premium. That is the reason.
Okay, okay, sir. But generally, sir, how much time it generally take to process a claim? Generally 1 month, 2 months, 5 months, 6 months?
Normally it is our agreement or trade, this one is that 60 days from the date of receipt of claim form, subject to after expiry of the 4 months from the due date, because the waiting period has to be over. So normally within 60 days you have to get the claim.
Okay, okay.
Sir, now I already have one policy. Okay, so at the time of renewal, annual renewal, they see if the outstanding anything is there above 6 months, then they don't renew the policy. Sir, but now last 2 years, exports has been so erratic, so many rollovers, all the consignment is reaching customer after 2-3 months. Mm. So all payments are getting delayed beyond 6 months. Mm.
Sir,
so in this case, what to do, sir?
Sir, very simple, sir. If the terms of payment is 180 days, then there is no problem. If the terms of payment, you say that 60 days from the date of arrival of the goods or date of receipt from the bill of lading date. Even it is assuming that 60 days, maximum time transit period from India to US or Mexico, which is the longest point, is only 62 days as per the FDI guidelines, as per the guidelines given by everybody. So another 60 days will take it, 120 days. 180 days is a too long a period, because we do not know that 6 months mein wo aadmi hai kya nahi. Iske liye they are asking it, they said wait for the maven to come. Hello.
Yes, sir, I got it. Thank you.
Yeah.
Hello.
Sir,
hello.
Sir, we have some questions
hello.
In chat box.
Can you please explain cross-country calculation?
What, madam?
Hello.
Hello.
Sir, can you please explain cross-country calculation of premium?
Cross-country calculation of premium. Very good. Madam, I will tell you. You are sending, your buyer is in A1 country, where the premium rate is 100 rupees or 1 rupee. I am giving an example, 1 rupee. And shipment is going to A2 country, where the premium rate is 1.5 rupees. Now, what you have to do is 25% of 1.5 rupees, where the goods goes, you take 25%, where it will be 37.50. Right? Then 75% of 1 rupee, which is 75. 75 plus 37.5, it will give you to you 112.50. You understood, madam?
Yes, sir.
better.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Hello.
Yeah.
Hello. Sir, as you mentioned, the commercial risks are not covered.
Commercial risk, nahin. Commercial disputes.
Yes, commercial disputes are not covered. And for example, if we do an open account, and if the buyer's intentions are not good, so generally he would raise a quality issue and reject the goods and not pay. So in that case, sir, how can we safeguard ourselves?
Sir, very good, sir. Open account may, first of all, open account transaction can be done only by status holder. Right, number one. Number two, open account, that's what I always tell you, when you send a open account, just once the goods reaches there, you have to have you have to develop a correspondence. Today, email, everything is there. Hope you are well. Have you received the goods? I think everything going on well. Is it okay? Like that, you just send a mail and take it. So that when the payment comes after 60 days, he will not be telling you, my goods are, your goods are not good. If the goods are reached there, if you are sending, hi, how are you? Goods reached, any issues? If he says, yes, your product, something is there, means that will be definitely something is there.
Okay, so we have to take confirmation from the buyer itself.
It is always better to take a confirmation, but do not mention about quality or anything. Just as a matter of routine, hope it is only a business follow-up. Hope you have received a material. Everything going on well. Like that, you have to try, sir. Danda karte samay hum log bahut bar different language mein baat karta hai. So market mein jayega to ek chota sa cheez ko hum log dusri tarah se wo log bata ke hum log ko bechta hai. Waise hi hum log ko apne buyer ko bolna hai ye aisa hai. Unko shak nahi aane ka hum log doubt kar rahe nahi hai. ऐसा ही जनरल टॉक में उसको कंफर्मेशन लेके रखने का बात
सही राइट नाउ यू सेड यू कैन नॉट डू ओपन अकाउंट एंड वी नीड टू बी अ समथिंग समथिंग
स्टेटस होल्डर यस
सॉरी
स्टेटस होल्डर
ओके सर थैंक यू
सर बट व्हाट इफ वी आर कस्टमर एक्सपेक्ट्स अस टू बी ओपन अकाउंट बट वी कैन वी डोंट हैव द टर्नओवर टू बी अ स्टेटस होल्डर So we are doing business at a risk in that case.
Sir, what you are selling, sir?
Like I am not a status holder, but I have an open account. Like I have running orders, I have open POs and everything. But
open account means goods are sent directly to the buyer. Documents are directly dispatched to the buyer, which is not permitted by RBI.
Okay. But our bank also sometimes refuses ki you should directly send it. Why? Like banks also hesitate to get involved sometimes.
If your banking banker says you send the document directly, why you are giving to me? Take that in writing.
Okay.
Because RBI is very strict on this. Even the master circular recently issued also says your banker, who is the authorized dealer, can permit you to send the document direct. If your banker says, yes, you send the document, take it in writing and keep it with you.
Okay, sir.
Hello, sir. I heard that you told that ECDC doesn't say no to the new exporters. But in my case,
why not apply for the home exporters? Sir, the voice is not feasible, sir.
We are not able to hear you.
Yeah.
Can you post your question in the chat box?
Yeah, sure.
Yeah.
Sir, we have Hello? A question in chat box.
Hello.
Yeah. Tell me, madam.
Yeah, it's Nigeria is not allowed to import finished pen products. So, can we have ECGC coverage for sending finished goods to client in Nigeria?
No, madam. They have to take a M form. The buyer has to obtain a M form in the local country. And if M form is obtained, ask the Indian exporter to take the copy of the M form before exporting it.
Sir, after taking MCOM, they can apply to the ECGC for export to Nigeria?
Yes, yes. They can apply now also. They can apply now also. But when a claim comes, we will ask whether buyer has got MCOM or not.
Sir, what is the whole turnover guarantee, sir?
See, that is given to a, like our, I am giving a cover to the exporters. We also give cover to the banker for the failure of the Indian exporters. That is for the bank.
So bankers are charging those premium to the exporter? How it is, sir?
See, that is, they will be charging to you only for the packing credit. See, packing credit is pre-shipment finance. Pre-shipment finance is nothing but they give you finance for the manufacture of the goods. They take a cover with ECEC in case you are not able to export. Bank, whatever they finance, they have to, they will take an insurance cover from ECGC. Under post-shipment, no bank will be charging your account.
Okay. So one more question. The premiums are charged as per the country wise?
Premium charge according to the country classification. We have classified the country into 7 groups. A1, A2, B1, B2, C1, C2, D. So premium rate depends on the, it is a matrix, depends on the country.
Hello, sir.
Yeah.
Hello. सर मुझे और एक क्वेरी है कि ईसीजीसी का जो रनिंग स्टेटस दिखाता है सीएलए फीस का वो एवरी मंथ चेंज क्यों होता है कोई कोई पार्टी उसमें से निकल क्यों जाती है कौन से बेसिस पे वो आप चेंज करते हैं
चेंज हम लोग चेंज नहीं करते मैडम 12 महीना आपने आज एक अप्रूवल ले लिया है आपने 12 महीने तक उसका वो बायर के ऊपर शिपमेंट नहीं किया तो वो ऑटोमेटिक कैंसिल हो जाता है
ओके और एक था उसमें अगर समझो पेंडिंग स्टेटस दिखा रहा है और मेरा शिपमेंट हुआ है तो उस केस में क्या होगा
कुछ नहीं हो गया आपका कवर डिस्क्रिशन लिमिट में कवर हो जाएगा और पेंडिंग स्टेटस बाद में अप्रूवल कर देगा पुराना डेट में जब आपने एप्लीकेशन दिया है उस डेट से अप्रूवल करेगा
ओके ओके थैंक यू
Sir, we have one more question. Can we take single buyer policy if we have full turnover credit policy with private insurance company?
No, you cannot have two insurance cover for the same buyer. It is not permitted by RBI or IRDA. For the same risk, you cannot have two. Can you take a cover for two times for your car insurance can you take two car policy you will have to have only one policy
but sir wo buyer ka private insurance company ne reject kar diya hai
ha
to main le sakta hu isi ke sath single buyer policy
if they have rejected then you can take it
okay okay thank you
hello sir is it audible now?
Yeah, tell me, sir.
Sir, I have applied for a small exporters policy 10 to 12 months back, but they denied me saying that as your business is new and you are new to the export business, we have checked your background and you don't have much of a turnover in your business over here, domestic. So we can't allow or give you any premium on that. And so a few weeks back only I went to this office in Rajkot, ECGC Rajkot, and again I have tried to explain them that I have purchase order also, so you just try to give me this small exporters policy premium, but then again they told me that there is very low less chance that we can give you the premium, but still you can apply for another time.
Not like that, sir. You can write a mail to our note a mail ID wro at ecgc.in.
Sorry, sir, can you repeat?
WRO, Western Regional Office, WRO@ecgc.in.
Okay, sir, thank you.
Excuse me, sir.
Yeah.
We have a new company and we are just going to start our exports after this Diwali. So is there any policy from first shipment we can buy in single policy for all countries?
No, your voice is not feasible, I think.
Hello?
Some echo is coming. I could not understand your question.
So meanwhile, there is one question in chat box. We'll take that one.
Yeah.
If I'm getting advance equal to 10 years of export, is ECGC available to bank for complete 10 years?
Bank? What is the reason for bank? I do not foresee any bank here, because when he has got an advance, what is the reason for bank asking for cover, or what is the reason for exporter asking for a cover? He need not go for a cover. He is already having a 10 years advance with him.
Okay. I think, sir, all the questions are completed right now. If anyone is having any questions, can send to us. Our email ID is office@plexcouncil.org. Someone please share the council's ID.
I think Mr. Mekana has given some question. He has asked, can we take a policy for the first shipment where my shipment is going to start in after Diwali? No problem, sir. You can take a policy now itself or after time of Diwali or whatever it is. It will be covered from the first shipment. From the date, if you are taking a policy from today, it will be covered from today. And if you are not exported for 2 months, you can say nil export.
Okay. Thank you, sir. Malingan, sir, thank you so much. Sir, Galani, sir, it's over to you, sir.
I must thank Mr. Mahalingam for a very
Sir, can we take a ECGC insurance for already shipped material which has not reached the customer yet?
No, sir. Okay. No. Cover can be from the date of shipment only. You have to take prior to the date of shipment or on the date of shipment.
Okay. Thank you, sir. Sorry.
Thank you, Mr. Mahalingam. Thank you very much for a very, very informative session. I'm sure all the members and all the participants have got new knowledge about export or insurance cover for exports. And you could see that there were a lot of enthusiasm in asking questions. So thank you once again for taking out time and giving us all this information. I thank all the participants for their time. Thank you very much. I hope you all got something from this webinar.
Can you send the email ID which madam has said, please? So
we'll be sharing. Yes, sir. We'll be sharing PPT to all the participants, sir.
Thank you, madam. Thank you all for
participating.
Thank you for giving me an opportunity to talk to many people. I also learned a lot by interacting with everybody. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much, sir, for being with us.
Thank you.
Thank you, Galani, sir. Thank you, Naman.
Thank you, Bharti. Bye.
Thank you very much.